The major concept of this EMI course is looking into the insight of light and matter. I am the instructor, Professor Zheng Yongzhen. The purpose of this class is to introduce the way light interacts with solids, and it is intended for the first year graduate students. We should know that light wave electromagnetic field is everywhere.Field source of electric field is charge. Field source of magnetic field is current. Time variation of charge and current generates electromagnetic field wave. Understanding the interaction of electric field and matter is important. Scientists are highly concerned about the study of polarization, phase, and propagation direction ofElectric field on matter. Electromagnetic interactions is one of the four fundamental interactions. Different types of chemical bonds lead to different outer electronic properties of solids. This is our course textbook, Optical Properties of Solids. The author is Professor Mark Fox.The book contains up-to-date account of the optical physics of solids. Here it shows the 11 chapters in the textbook. Chapter 1, Introduction. Chapter 2, Classical Propagation. Chapter 3, Interband Absorption. Chapter 4, Acetones. Chapter 5, Luminescence. Chapter 6, Quantum Confinement.Chapter 7, Free Electrons. Chapter 8, Molecular Materials. Chapter 9, Luminescence Centers. Chapter 10, Phonons. Chapter 11, Nonlinear Optics. I plan to teach from Chapter 1 to Chapter 8 in this course. In the chapter of introduction, we should knowThere are four types of light matter interactions. They are absorption, reflection, luminescence, and scattering. In the chapter of classical propagation, we are going to look into questions like, why are metal and diamond shiny? Why do crystals show specific color?We should understand the dielectric spectroscopy. In the chapter of interband absorption, we should learn more about energy band gap. In the chapters of acetone and luminescence, we should know that acetone is a bond state of electron and hole. They are attracted to each other by electrostatic Coulomb force.Strong acetonic luminescence can be observed at low temperature of semiconductors. Enhanced photoluminescence from condensed electron hole pairs in changed silicon is reported in our researches. In the chapter of semiconductor quantum wells, QWs, we should know thatQWs are effective nanostructures for confining electrons and holes, acetones. Light emitting devices contain QWs, for example, LEDs, can have strong electroluminescence. Optimal silicon doping layers of quantum barriers in the growth sequence forming soft confinement potential of aperiodicindium gallium nitride quantum wells or blue LEDs is reported in our investigations. In the chapter of free electrons, plasmon is a quantum of plasma oscillation. Plasmons are collective oscillations of free electron gas density. Surface plasmon resonance behavior at the grating structure of highly geodoped zinc oxide is shown in our recent article published. In the chapter of molecular materials, two-dimensional 2D materials show fantastic behavior. photoreflectance study of the near band-edge transitions of chemical vapor deposition grown mono and few layer MOS2 films is shown in our study. Finally, I would like to say, attend the class on time, ask questions at any time, write homework, practice more. Welcome to attend this course. Thank you for watching this video.